So I just got on the phone with a client who is a first-time home buyer, and he wants to buy a $300,000 house. He says, "Hey Brian, want to buy a $300,000 house? I got between 3% and 5% to put down. I got an 800 credit score. I've been at my job for 2 years. You know, what do I need to do?" I told him, "Okay, perfect. You need to complete an application, some of your last 2 years W-2s, two most recent pay stubs, last 2 months bank statements from wherever your down payment's going to come from. Once that point, I'll get everything dialed in for you same day, review it, give you a call, and go over your approval for you." And he was just kind of like, "Okay, that sounds cool." And he, you know, kind of caught me off guard. I'm like, "Okay, that's fast. Like, what's he not so happy about?" And then it occurred to me, because the last time that he had done something where he wanted any type of decent amount of money was when he got student loans. Think about it. He was 18 years old and he goes to his college and he says, "Hey college, I want to go here. I'm 18 years old. I have no credit. I don't have a job. My parents aren't going to co-sign for me. And I want you to pay for my education or give me money for my education, plus money for room and board and all my books. By the way, I have no job. I have no income. Will you give it to me?" And what happens? Mr. Financial Planner guy, financial aid, student loan aid, says, "Oh, no job, no income, gonna do some type of major? Yeah, no problem. Here's $250,000 to go to school here. And when you get out of school, no big deal, worry about it and pay us back." Like, think about that. Think about how screwed up our system is that a guy at 18 years old can go to a college who has no job, no money, no credit, and we just give them subsidized student loans with zero down. And then we expect, when there's an entitlement issue that comes up, when they come to buy their first house and we're telling them that they have to put 3% down or 5% down, and we need to verify income, we need to verify their credit, and they're like shocked by it. And it never occurred to me in 16 years until it just light bulb went off in my head. I'm like, no wonder they're shocked by it. Because back in the day, when my parents went to college, guess what? There was no subsidies for student loans. Guess what? Yeah, you could get some student loans, but you still had to pay your way through school. So it's the whole reason why people today are entitled when it comes to having to put money towards buying something, is a simple fact that it starts out at the earliest time when they among themselves go and try to pay for something, and they pay for college with no job, no credit, nothing, and they get a finance full college plus finance all their living expenses. So next time when we're thinking about why this next generation is so entitled, I guarantee you, if you rethink it, you'll realize, yes, it is their problem for being entitled, but it's the government's problem for subsidizing everybody's education with no concrete plan on really how you ever gonna pay it back.